Hello everyone. In the previous video, we have seen how various programming features can be implemented using JavaScript language. Now in this video, we will try to understand about how do we design and develop the graphical user interfaces with using the JavaScript language. So basically, the user interactivity with the system is done with the help of a graphical user interface which can be designed and developed using JavaScript language. Before we proceed to how do we design and develop a GUI consisting of various controls or various objects and so on and so forth, let us complete understanding the document object methods and the properties that are available with the JavaScript. So the built-in object, the document, which always refers to the current a web page document which you are trying to make use of with respect to the browser. So the built-in object, the document, has got different methods which can be used for various purposes. You can open the document using the open method. Similarly, you can close the document. You can write something to the present existing document, and as well as you can write it in terms of the new lines is going for the new set of characters on the new lines. So let us see with an example how we can use the document object to open and to write a new line or one particular sentence to the existing web page document. So I am using this code. So this is basically the JavaScript is embedded onto the HTML code. Copy the code, then open the new file. Yes, in the new file, I have edited the file. So you can see there is the various HTML elements. The elements which are here is basically the head tag. The head tag contains the title of that particular web page, and followed by the body section. In the body section, we have the paragraph tag. The paragraph element contains, this is the line of text specified in the HTML file. So let us now just run that particular this particular program and see what is the output we are getting. So I'm saving this file into the sample JS codes file. So this is example py.html. Once you save the file, you can see this is a very simple file. You can open the example file with your browser. So once you open the file, you can see that there is only one line which is displayed on the document, that is your current web page. So this is a line of text specified in the HTML file. You are not seeing any other contents on this web document. So now let us see if we try to add the script tag, the JavaScript tag, with two different statements. One is for opening the document, and you are writing something to this document. So this is a line of text written to the document using JavaScript. So using the JavaScript, you are going to write another line onto the same web document. And these two statements, document.open and the document.write, are written under the script tags. So now let us save this file. And you can refresh this file now. Now you see this is a second line. So this second line is written with the help of document.write statement, where the document object is writing something to this document itself. Suppose you want to write something to another new document or to a new web document, something like this. You want to navigate to another web document, and that document has to display something else. It means basically you are trying to invoke a new document from the existing document, or in other terms, you usually go from one document to the another document, or you can navigate from one web page to another web page, and you want to display and try to process some data, so on and so forth. So this particular feature can also be used with the document object. You can open the new, let me just close this one. So how do we open a new window, and the new window, how do we invoke the document object's write function into the new window? So let me just take the sample code. So now I am trying to go for the new file and editing the program. Save as, this is example 6. .html. So save the program here. Right, now let us see what is exactly happening here. So I have the function declaration and the corresponding definition here, something called as write content. So now the write content is what is going to happen here in the body tag. I have something. Now in the body tag, what is that? Another script file. So here we are using window.open. A new window is getting opened. There's a new window, or you can open a tab too. So that is going to be the new object. So that object here is, that is a new window object, which is basically opening a new window. And once that new window is opened, so what is that you are written under the form element, that is a button. So when you are providing a button here, so the value of that button is write to a new window. You want to write it to a new window, something the content. This is a new content in the new window. And that particular object is then object which is invoking that new window. And the definition for that write content, that is the write content function that you have been using here, which takes two parameters. One is the content itself, that is the text that you want to write it onto this new window, and the window object, the current window object is the new window object, which is being passed onto this function write content. And that there, so you are using the window object. So this is a built-in object, window object. So this is, sorry, this is the window object, the user defined window object. So this is a built-in object document. So the document object is invoking the method write to display the content that has been passed on from when the user clicks this button, write to window button is being clicked. So let us see the execution of this program. Save this program, go to the file, then open example 6. Open with your browser. So you can see that now there are two windows. So one window has been opened here, but the content is not written, which is very blank here. So now you go back to this one. This is the previous, or that is the original window. When you click this button, write to new button. Now you can see this this new document, that is a new object document, has got a new content on this one, which you are able to write it onto the new document. So this is how you can navigate from one web document to another document with the help of window.open and passing on the corresponding values through your functions. So this is how we can navigate from one document to another document using the document.write. So let us now move on to the JavaScript and the form object. So the JavaScript, the beauty of the JavaScript is to have the design and development of a graphical user interface. When I say design and development, you are trying to design the particular document with various elements, various components, various objects. So I can call it as elements, I can call it as objects, and I can even call it as components, and so on and so forth. So whenever you are developing a GUI, the graphical user interface, where the user is interacting with the system with the help of the GUI. So this GUI, in short, we call it as, that GUI has to be designed in a very user friendly manner. So in order to design with a very user friendly approach, the GUI can be having the various components or the various elements, in other terms, various objects onto that GUI. With the help of using the form object itself, you are going to put embed, or you are going to place various elements onto this GUI. So the form object is like a container which keeps holding all that particular set of elements that you are going to be placed onto the graphical user interface. So the, now the form container, that's what we call it as here, as a form tag. It also takes a several number of attributes. Depending on your application requirements, different attributes will be made use of for various purposes. So the basic attributes this form tag supports are, one is the name. So you are going to give the name of the form, which will be used for referencing various objects within the form. So whenever you place some components or elements into this form, so those elements or objects can be referred with respect to this particular current form. Similarly, you have another attribute called method. That method is basically refers to whether you are getting some values into the form or whether you are going to post some values that must be sent to some other location such as server or to some other file to get for data processing. So now along with the method, you have another attribute called action. So this action will enable us to what exactly this form has to do once it has been made use by the user. Then you have another attribute called onSubmit. So onSubmit is something like an event which is going to happen when the user clicks that particular event or invokes that particular, the event is being invoked with by the user. What is that corresponding action that needs to be done, and that event you need to be traced out what to be done by the corresponding user, such as validating and trying to process the data which is to be sent to some other location or process in the browser itself. So some example, something like that you write is form is a tag name followed by the attribute name, and you are giving some name to that particular form, such as registration form, student registration form. Method, you are getting some values from some other file. Here in this case, this is just an example, the CGS script file. From there, some values have been obtained to this particular form, and whatever the values you obtain here, you're going to make use of those values for different form objects, so on and so forth. This is just a simple syntax to how to use the form tag here. Similarly, you can, there's another example how to use the form tag. Here you have something called simply an action. Here it is very the value of that particular action attribute is empty. It means you need not do anything, just simply you are going to type some values into these form objects. Then you are trying to means you are also giving a name to this particular form, such as the element, such as the input type is equal to text. You might have seen in the HTML coding what is this input tag is referring to. That is a user input that you are trying to get it, and that particular information that you are getting into this particular form is of text type or a text categorical value. Then the name of this particular input which you are giving, that are referring to that with a specific name, the unique name, the phone number, and you're giving certain ID also. Sometimes you may have to give the specific IDs which will be useful for you to refer to these objects, the such as these input objects, and what is the corresponding value. And you can see you need not give explicitly the closing tag for this one as well. You can try to close the corresponding input tag here by specifying the forward slash at the end of this open tag, which implies to the browser that is the end of that particular script tag. So let us see what are the various elements that you can place it. That's what are the various objects that you can place it. In other terms, various components that you can place it on your GUI. We have elements such as simply the input type as a text. So this text is like an input box in the graphical user interface, which you see is an input box here. The text which has been placed under the container form tag. So this along with the name, you can also specify the size, you can specify the other attributes, the color, and so on and so forth. Suppose you are entering a password, obviously that input type is a password. You need to specify that it is a password so that the characters cannot be seen by the user respectively. So you can specify the size for how many characters the user need to enter, and you are going to give a specific name so that it can be referred for the various other components in the web document. You also have something called as your submit button. So submit button always will be a button click. So here that needs to be interacted with the user. You're going to submit some information. So at the end of the GUI, you'll have something called button called submit. As well as you have other form controls like the radio button. You can see user is going to select one among the several elements of this set of values that you can provide with the radio buttons. Similarly, you have a selection of particular set of values, which you call it a select tag itself, which use the separate values of this one. You can use the select tag. So this is how you are giving the values as an optional values here. And whereas for the radio buttons, you are giving the corresponding values as red, green, and blue, whatever it may be with respect to different applications. Let us run a small program and try to understand how these form controls can be very much useful, and how JavaScript is helping to do some extra work that is called as form validation. That is one of the important feature of your JavaScript to do validation, that is a checking at the user end only before the data is actually sent to the server or to be the data to be processed in the later stages. So let me just open one GUI which I have just designed here for you to make it understand. Of course, the design is not very attractive one, but nevertheless, you'll make you to understand what this particular design is. So you can see here, there is a student registration form. So here see there are components on this web document. All these components are placed under the form container. So you can see this is a text box, which is having a certain size here. And these are all text boxes, the name text box, the address. So what you see on the left side is basically a label. So this particular input type is basically a label. There's a name, address, email address, passwords, telephone, and select your course. This particular text, what you see is basically there, the label objects. So what you see here is the boxes. This is basically your text boxes. So you can, in the common box, you can see this text box is somewhat different from the previous boxes. This particular box is called as a text area, where it can support multi-line and as well as multiple number of set of characters to be stored here under the comment section. Along with this one, you see there are two buttons. One button is called send and another button is called resetting. Reset will make obviously to reset the values which have been entered by the user here. So of course the design is not with me. So in order to make a proper design, you can use cascading style sheets so that your boxes looks very much attractive for the user to enter and so on and so forth. But let us see how do we write this program and how the validation takes place here. It means how you make use of the JavaScript to design as well as to develop. The develop in the sense you write the codes for various buttons. When the user clicks that button, what is that the event handling should takes place, and how the validation is going to be performed. It means how the user is entering the required and the correct values to be entered before the data is actually passed on to the server, or before the data is being exchanged to some other programs. So let me open the program. The program for that student registration form, very simple form. So here I'm opening with the Notepad editor. Now you can see here, so there is a function. Let me just, before going to the function, let us go to the your body tag. So you have an here the heading tag. That's what you can see in the first line. The student registration form is a head one. You have different heading tags like H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6, and you are aligning to the center of your web page. That's what you can see. The head tag is at the center of this. Your text has been aligned to the center. That has been, the style has been made. The text element as center, that's one of the attribute you have made it here for the H1 tag. So followed by you have the form tag, which is a container for holding various other elements here. So what you see here is basically the labels and all has been kept as simply the text itself here under the paragraph. So you can see this is a paragraph tag. So this is under one paragraph tag. You have a label text, that is name, followed by you have a text box. So the text box is, again, it is a text box which is collecting the data from the user, that is the input. So you are using the input tag, which is of type text, and you're specifying the text box size, your data consists of 65 characters, and you're giving a name to that particular text box, that is the input type, that is a name itself as a name. That is the end of this, and you're inserting the break tag so that you can now move on to the next line to collect the data, such as the address, email address, the password. Here the text type, you are going to give as a text only here. If you want, you can change it to the password. At present, I have just given the text to see the set of characters, then followed by the telephone. Now you can see the select box, the select tag has been made used to provide some selection to be made by the user. So such as you can pick up one among these particular set of options that are made available to here. So you can see the comments is being made with the text area with a specific number of characters, means a specific size, the number of columns. So you are getting here, and the input types are of two buttons here, which is a submit button, which is basically a button itself, and you can give a submit. It implies that you are going to send the data. So once you click on submit button, so you can see here the action tag. So here at present I'm keeping it as an empty. So later I will, you can give some to, if the, once the submit button is pressed, this particular, if I write something, the file name, something like send to server.php. So obviously this is a file which is going to be sent. This file is going to be located on the server side. If once this particular submit button is clicked, later we'll see how this PHP is going to take all this set of values and all. At present, I'm not giving any value here. Here you can understand that this action button will imply that you are going to send it to a so-and-so page once the submit button is clicked. But on submit, on the user clicks this one, you have mentioned that there must be something to be validated. Validated in the sense whether the user is entering the data correctly or not, as per your requirements. So you have written a JavaScript function. So that function name is register form validation, something like a reg form validation. This JavaScript function here itself is embedded in your head section itself. So here reg form. So what is exactly happening? This function, as you see, how do you write the functions and all in the previous videos, you have seen it. Now let us understand here. So I'm collecting using the document object, that is the forms that I have given the name of this form. The name of the form is, the name of the form, what I have given is, this is the advantage of giving the name to that particular form so that you can refer to this corresponding object, reg form. So I'm referring to this. If you can put multiple forms in the same document, you can refer to the multiple forms. But here you have reg form. Under the reg form, again, I'm referring to a specific element, that is the name. So I'm collecting that particular, whatever the user is entering into this box, I'm collecting that particular corresponding value into a temporary variable, the name itself here. So similarly, all the other elements, I am trying to retrieve this, whatever the user is entered into the corresponding temporary variables here. So now I'm going to make use of these variables, the user specified variables here, to check or to validate with certain constraints, such as if the user is not entered the value, which is the value is empty. So then I'm going to make an alert. So window.alert, please enter your name. And the name.focus, that particular text box is getting focused here. So, and you are waiting for that. So once that is been entered, obviously this particular statement condition will be false. Then obviously the next set of values are going to be checked. So until, if you, all the statements, if you keep it in the if statements, it implies that the user is compulsorily has to enter the all the required fields. And of course you can put more conditions here, the required number of characters, the required number of sizes, or to be specific characters, you can put the regular expressions here properly, make sure that proper validations can be incorporated here. So how do you write regular expressions and how do you make the other conditions to be incorporated? That you can see with the set of examples that you are given in the textbooks, so that you can practice it in a proper way. So once you save this particular program, so you can, let us see how this goes on run. So if I enter some values here, the dummy values, and if I simply press enter, obviously it is giving, please enter your address. So it is asking for me to enter the address. Now, once I entered the address, then again, once again, I'm clicking here. So again, it is asking, please enter a valid email address. So email address, of course, the expression that it should contain @, or it should contain .com or .gmail, that exact, a specific set of constraints I have not kept it, but nevertheless, the one constraint I kept it is it should not be null. So you can write your own set of constraints accordingly. Then you can try to check. So here, please enter your telephone number. So the telephone number, again, it should be a number only, it should not be a characters. Then again, you can write the corresponding text, but as of now, it will try to accept that particular, because I have not kept the other set of restrictions. So once you perform this validation, that is the advantage of JavaScript. It performs validations of the user inputs at the browsing side itself. So some data is getting processed here, that is being done with the help of JavaScript. So do practice and let us see how the next video will go for the document object model. So how do you make use of this? We'll see it in the next video. Yeah, thank you. And just 1 second, all this material had been referred from this particular textbook, the JavaScript. So you can see other example, set of examples, and make the proper practice with the exercises that we are giving in the lab. Thank you.